Hello, welcome back to Kaiserreich, or potentially welcome for the first time to Kaiserreich, because this is technically the beginning of a new series, though it is also technically the continuation of a previous one. I did a United States playthrough, which was a short prologue to both this series and a series which you should already have seen by now, been released, which is a series on the Combined Syndicates of America. So basically, I'm doing a parallel playthrough of different nations in the American Civil War. And this is the first episode of the Pacific States of America. So, Douglas MacArthur has taken over the executive. He now sits in the White House. We have a syndicalist uprising in the North called the CSA. And then we have a sort of nationalist, like militia-based uprising in the South, under Huey Long, with some alliances with some unscrupulous fellows. Anyways, we will stand by the Republic. Well, let's see here. We've got a bunch of armies, but no leaders for them. Let's figure out how to organize these. We've got the Oregon State Guard. Some National Guards. I have to change those symbols. I'm using the MPU division mod, which I talked about this in the first, or division icons mod and theater icons mod. I talked about this in the first episode of the United States playthrough. So you can look at it there, and you can also find all the mods in the mod list in the description down below. Let's see here. So let's change these, because I don't like that symbol. We'll probably have to do it over here. PSA garrison, there we go. So what should the State Guard symbol be? Oh, this is this is great for the syndicalists, I guess. Oh, this is cool. So you can have like green for army units, and you can have blue for like technically navy units and stuff. Because, you know, the US Navy has a bunch of ground troops known as I suppose Marines. Maybe we should have something tan like this. There you go, Oregon State Guard. Or the just various state guards. And then you got the National Guard, which are a normal infantry template. Though technically, so a good way of using this system, you can while using the system, you can actually find a good way of easily being able to tell how many men are in each division that you have by marking them correctly. Like these markings here actually indicate various sizes of units. So 3 stars is a corps, and 2 is a regiment, I believe, and 1 is a brigade. And let's see. So these guys are infantry, and they are. They're not corps sized, I think. They are regiment sized, I think. I'm not quite sure. I'll look that up in between episodes, but right now we've got them all set up. And you've got the motorized. These are National Guard, but they have a different template. California National Guard. That's interesting. Oh, so some use the PSA Infantry Division and some use the Infantry Division template. That's a bit annoying. I'll probably just change them to the PSA template so we can have them all in one unified template in case we want to change all of them. There we go. And then we have the motorized. First California motorized, and I think that's it in terms of our troops. Yeah, it is. Let's get them all in one army. So we are defending the Republic in these turbulent times. We'll probably need a bunch of mountain troops because of all this. The California National Guard, or actually we'll call them the Pacific National Guard. That's a mouthful. Pacific National Guard works better. Yep, there you go. Yellow for the color of the sun. Which, of course, we all know, exclusively resides in the West. And in terms of army color, we'll do this because it is technically a full army. Or sorry, army icon. And then we'll need a general. Let's look at the generals for the Pacific States. We've got Alexander Patch, I've seen him before. Isaac D. White, I'm not quite sure if I've seen him before, but there's always a lot of information about the generals in the American, in America in this game. Or well, the Americas, actually. The Canadians, I believe, and the South American ones have an absurd amount of detail. So Isaac D. White, he is very interested in the adoption of tanks and mechanized vehicles over infantry combat, but his ambitions may have to wait until the Civil War is over. Cool. So he's going to be a tank commander then. We've got a... this guy looks like a Special Forces guy, possibly Marines, or... let's see... Banana Wars in Cuba. Occupation of Veracruz. Haiti, or Haiti, I'm not quite sure how you guys pronounce it. I'm not quite sure what he would be. Maybe he could be a Ranger type dude. Raritan, Brigadier General. He's like an artillery corps guy. James H. Doolittle. Oh, that's the famous Doolittle raid. He's a brilliant aviator and strategist. He is a remarkably fast learner. Faster learner than his colleagues. That's kind of a strange. It's a fine sentence, but it was just like strange for me to read it. A staunch defender of democracy, even within the army, which has sparked some controversy for his superiors. Alright, so I think Doolittle will probably be our paratrooper dude, just because of his aviation background. The famous Doolittle raid, by the way, was the raid after the, bombing of Pearl Harbor, in order to bomb Tokyo or something like that, in order to, in response to the bombing of Americans, they wanted to bomb, the Japanese, to show that they had the capability. Of course, they did not have the capability to come back, so they had to land, I believe, in China. Alright, so we do have some field marshals here. Let's just set an infantry-minded general, who is quite good as well, in charge of our... it might be Alexander Patch, honestly. In charge of the army itself, and then the field... Marshal will be so Field Marshal George Marshall or Field Marshal Henry H. Arnold. So we got a politically tolerant man, or we got a let's look at their stats then, because I can't actually decide based on just their oh dude, this guy has charismatic, that's such a good trait. This guy has offensive doctrine, also very good trait. I'm gonna go with H. Arnold though. I couldn't decide based on their backgrounds, so I went for their traits instead. Wondering if we get some unique music for this. I'm gonna skip the American Patrol, it's a good song, but I want to see if we get some new music for the Pacific States. I don't think so. I think it's all based on the US music list. When we play the Command Syndicates of America, they give you way more worker songs and revolutionary songs and stuff like that. And of course, when you play the Germans, you get a lot of German music and so on and so forth. Let's have a look at, standoff in America. This 10th standoff has erupted in the United States as democratically elected President Reed fled to the country, or the city of Chicago. That's him. After being forcibly removed from his position by General Douglas MacArthur. From Chicago, Reed's supporters had declared MacArthur's government illegitimate, as have the southern supporters of Huey Long. Huey Long here, and Douglas MacArthur. So, and also the governors under the leadership of Governor Frank Merriam. in the Pacific states. So the governor has taken over. All have been given a deadline by General MacArthur of 30 days to either stand down or face arrest and execution. So we have 30 days to do something. And we should create the Western Command. That is the most important thing right now. Western Defense Command. Since we claim to be the real America and our army is officially the United States Army, the command hierarchy remains unclear on many levels. As such, we'll push for the creation of the Western Defense Command, an apparent detachment of the army which will work independently and will reunite with the army in structure once the Civil War is won. Once, of course, yes. We're building a fuel refinery. I'm not quite sure our fuel silo. Why, though? Current fuel 11k, daily gain 3.7k, and consumption nothing, but we might get more consumption later on. We have oil, don't we? We have a shit ton of oil. We don't need this. It's going to give us a higher threshold, but we don't need it right now. We're going to need it later, potentially. Once we start, like, you know, trading and, not even trading, we're just, like, projecting our force across the seas. Before I build anything, I want to look at what we actually need. So first, I'm going to start building some, or training some, infantry divisions here. I'm not going to build any tanks yet. I'll train new special template division. Why is that? Do I not have mountain? No, I do not. I do not have mountain infantry. Well then, fucking stop this bullshit and start this. Because we were researching some dumb shit. We're gonna go with one of these two, not Grand Battle Plan. Right, let's see, we are going to... That stuff started to be automatically researched by the AI, I think, once we... or before we even tag switched. I guess we'll finish these. I'm not gonna build these stupid submarines. What are you doing, AI? Beltkrieg? Yo, this is... Nah. We'll sort that stuff out later on. We do need those, though, but we do need these way more. God, we have no military factories, do we? Alright, let's erect those real quick so we can build, or just assemble our guns. No divisions in basic training, which is a problem, but we don't even have enough guns to outfit them. So it doesn't really matter much. Yeah, fuck the loyalist garrison, we don't need that. We don't have any of those. I wanna, you know, we're gonna make the armies and everything, it's gonna be very, like, it's gonna be Pacific. By the way, if you saw the thumbnail, it's using the state flag of California, not this flag, because I couldn't actually find an HD version of this flag, not even in the files of the game. It wasn't HD enough to, you know, fit the thumbnails. It would be kind of blurry, so I went with a Pacific States, or with the California-based Pacific State flag, which is still pretty cool. What if we get a decision to change our flag? AI setup templates, what? Let's see, we can recruit militia, and we should do that, because that takes time. We're gonna recruit militia in Northern California first, because that's where we get the most. The Pacific Declaration. Ever since the first peaceful transfer of power between George Washington and John Adams, the government of the United States has prided itself on respecting the wishes of its population after an election. I need to turn this down because it's mind-flooding me a lot. Very loud song. This unspoken contract between the people and their government has been violated by General Douglas MacArthur. In deposing the democratically elected president in the name of preserving stability, he shattered the founding principles of our nation. The destruction of the healthy civil-military relationship has marked America since the independence is a grievous slight to all values we hold as a nation. In response, the governors of California, Washington, and Oregon have issued a joint declaration condemning the general's actions and demanding his immediate withdrawal from Washington. We doubt that he will respond positively, but like the Patriots in 1776, we must make a stand against tyranny and oppression for the Republic. Alright, insufficient resources, we've got to trade. Portugal is a good trading partner. So is Germany, actually. Germany station is going to have some trouble, though, I think. They have some trouble. Germany station here is at war with the Indochinese Union. Also, I gotta say, if you're not even aware what Kaiserreich is, which, how are you here? I explained that in the first video of the United States campaign. I'm not going to explain it here as well. But, I mean, look at the map and you can sort of infer what's happening here. You know, things are a bit more red in some places, and things are a bit more monarchist in some places. But yeah, we're not going to trade with the Commune of France, so that's kind of silly. We'll trade with the Russian Republic, why not? That's not too far of a journey to get that steel to us. And who are you guys? They are merging into fleets, oh my fucking god. The AI has made just, yeah, the AI has done a number on this. Riots in New England and New York. Alright, I need to skip some of these just so that we can get moving. Empire of Japan took two states from Transamur. So Japan puppeted the Transamur Republic, and it is now led by Spiridon Merkulov, former leader of the pro-Japanese provisional Primorsk government. Federal control maintained in Minnesota. Alright. Minnesota remains under MacArthur's control. North Carolina declares support for Huey Long. One should expect so. So we should choose our chief of staff. So our choices are Henry Arnold, Samuel D. Sturgis Jr., and Alexander Vandergrift. Samuel D. Sturgis Jr., Division Organization and Recovery Rate, that's a good one. Alright, actually tells you here. Arnold is Artillery Production Cost, that's good. Well, as Artillery, his General Artillery Doctrine, and then we have Special Forces. We don't even have Special Forces, so I'm going to go with Samuel D. Sturgis Jr. at the moment. The Artillery is good, I might go with it later on. Some of these nations, your appointments to various positions has a hefty, like, effect on your... Oh, Finland joined the Reichspact. Whoa. Has a hefty effect on your, like, politics. So, Frank Merriam, in coordination, with governors of Oregon and Washington, issued a stunning public statement today. In it, he claimed that if the so-called protector of American values could not even respect the basic rights outlined in the Constitution, referring to Douglas MacArthur, I mean, who else, it would be up to the people of the Pacific to defend America's inalienable rights. Claiming that MacArthur's overthrow of the government was illegitimate, a new election would be held to select a new president, albeit amongst a limited slate of candidates in the Pacific region. Still, according to Merriam, whoever won this election would still have more legitimacy than MacArthur, and would be asked or tasked with overseeing the return of the nation to democracy by force if need be. That's interesting. I hope the plan is for them to have another election once everything is unified, because seems kind of a very limited electorate. Longest militias take control of Tennessee. Now they have a very straight border here. Let's see. We gotta have a look at our navy before we actually start doing anything with it. I'm going to have the entire navy merge in one place so that I can analyze exactly what we have in a more, in a manner in which oversight is a bit easier. New York declares for Jack Reed. Syndicalist riot. Following Jack Reed's own declaration of MacArthur's illegitimacy, many people hoped that the capitalists and syndicalists could come together and preserve American democracy. Those naive aspirations were dashed when Governor Merriam ordered the National Guard to violently suppress a syndicalist protest which broke out in Sacramento. This escalated into widespread rioting across many western cities, with Seattle in particular descending into violence. Longshoremen and Teamsters broke into Seattle City Hall and proclaimed the city loyal to Reed's Workers' Republic in Chicago. Currently, the city's in a tense standoff between National Guard units and the rebels held up in the City Hall. So this was in Sacramento. And, or Seattle. There's Seattle, and where's Sacramento? Because Sacramento is, yeah, that's our capital. Okay, so here's what I'm thinking. We should set, we've got people there, and we also did recruit the California militias. Let's recruit the Oregon militias, just so we have troops in the north there. So we'll probably have to, divide our forces up a little bit here now, so that we can have, a bit more of a neatly organized structure, so that we can actually have people assigned to where they're actually going to be useful. For example, the militias, judging by their name, yeah, so they're probably not going to be that useful for anything other than holding a line, while the garrison troops can potentially be useful as well, as in some manner, or like in some manner in terms of holding key positions, like for example Seattle and stuff, while these guys will be the ones we'll actually be using for the actual fighting. Like if you look at these guys, they are, you know, they're worse than the militias in terms of holding something. So I'm gonna have this guy move to Seattle as well, and I'll have someone moved to San Francisco as well, I think. I'll handle that after the episode, unless we actually get tossed into war immediately. Chief of the Army. With the Civil War raging all around us, and the fact that we do not have a chief of the army has prompted concern among many, or among various political and military leaders. Thus, they met with Frank Merriam to appoint a chief of the army to win this war. So got Alexander McCarroll's Sandy Patch. Division attack, that's good. This one is also good, against some butter. Frank Dow Merrill and Isaac D. White. So this is the, yeah, this is the tank, tank dude. Not gonna be useful to us at all, I don't think. I think Guns and Butter is the best one because the, organization and the supply consumption. Organization is just, that is what, you know, that's what you fight over in this game. So I'm gonna go with, which one was the organization boy? Dow Merrill. Yeah, so organization is what actually keeps your troops fighting. Strength is can keep get your troop like wiped out completely, while organization is what keeps them, or what makes them flee, what makes them retreat. And that is how you lose most battles, through a retreat. When you can no longer fight, that that's basically how most wars are fought. It's whenever your enemy is unable to fight, that's when you won. No sooner, no later. Where are the militias? They are in Northern California, so I'll just place them there. And these guys are State Guard, which I'll just probably unassign the commander, so we don't have any commander on that. Reassign him here. Motorized, we've got a dude there as well. Second Internationale. And also, Argentina declared war on the Patagonian Workers' Front. Happens quite often. War between syndicalists and nationalists in the south. And oh my god, Paraguay declared war on Argentina. So a Chilean-Argentinian war. So basically, the southern tip of South America is embroiled in a multi-front war. The Second Internationale is the organization, or the alliance, basically, economic and defensive between the various syndicalist nations in the world, and the various syndicalist movements in the world send representatives to the Trade Union Congress, Congress of the Internationale in London. Federal revolt fails in Texas, so Texas tried to break free from Huey Long. That's crazy if that actually happened. Paraguay declared war on Bolivia. It's popping off down there. Is we need a chief of the Air Force. Well, we have three options: Howard Hughes, Henry Arnold, and Oscar Westover. So Howard Hughes is air superiority. That's the one I generally go for, because if you don't have that, you can't really have anything else. And so is App Arnold, I think. Yeah, they both have the same doctrine, air superiority doctrine. And then you got Oscar Westover, which is close air support. I mean, we're gonna go with one of these guys. Who are these guys? I actually don't know who they are. If you do know, please do let me know in the comments down below, because that helps me, helps me contextualize the history of this this world, and also helps me make decisions. I'm gonna go with Henry Hap Arnold. Oh, Henry Harley Hap Arnold. We've got the entire Navy grouped together, which is good. We've got the Yorktown, Texas, Idaho. A lot of ships here. First thing you do is you split up all the submarines and create another fleet with that. Of course, we'll not have that symbol. It will have something like, oh, it'll probably be squadrons. So we'll have like first submarine squadron or first submarine flotilla, and then we'll have this to indicate that they are submarines. Let's see. We'll do that first, or like I'll sort it out. It'll be like, you know, something like that, but reversed because of the nature of the stars there, which indicate the size. But I'll do that later on in the next, or between the next episodes, or between this and next, rather. Election violence. Holy shit. A, this song goes hard, and B, there are so many events. Tensions between the Pacific states and Washington have remained high over the last weeks. But today, in the lead-up to the new election, they erupted into open conflict. While some of the ships in Naval Base San Diego were transferred to the East Coast after the first sign of unrest, many remained, though with sailors from across the country. Details are sketchy, but it appears a base commander, on orders from Washington, ordered sailors to take weapons from the base armory and head into the city. Okay, deploying themselves at polling places, they prevented poll workers from setting up. When morning came, large mobs surrounded these soldiers and began pelting them with rocks, bottles, and other debris. One of the soldiers hit by a bottle fired back, and soon the city descended into chaos. California National Guard units were deployed, and pitched street battles between sailors loyal to MacArthur and the guardsmen erupted, turning the tranquil city into a war zone. Fuck you, MacArthur. I'm not going to choose any of these yet, because I like Panzer Expert, but it's not only going to be useful once we have... actually, Combined Arms is also really good, but I think it's divisions, not actually motorized brigades in the divisions themselves. So if we go with Combined Arms, it's not actually going to affect Panzer Divisions or Armor Divisions. It's only going to affect motorized divisions. of which we'll have less because I want to have tanks in all of my motorized divisions.
Attention. Listen up.
Also, we have a few days, so we should probably just exercise. Well, not exercise these guys, because we don't really need them to fight a lot, but we should probably exercise a lot of our troops, just so that we get them up to speed before things go tits up. The new 1937 election. Despite the chaos in San Diego, elections proceeded in an orderly fashion, and many other cities along the Pacific coast, with limited unrest. General MacArthur is said to be furious at this open flouting of the sanctity of law and order, and declared that a new so-called president would be subject to the same punishment as Huey Long and Jack Reed if he did not immediately surrender the coast to the federal government. The mood in the western states is one of defiance, and the leader they have elected as the legitimate head of the American government is... Well... Well, well... So the intent here is that I'm going to try to record a bunch of these episodes in bulk. So rather, like, normally I would ask, who should I elect, and then end the video here, because it's a perfect time. However, I need to start recording more of these so that I can get them ready to release them while I am on a short vacation coming up. So I'm going to just pick one. But I want to look at them. So we can pick the governor of California, Frank Merriam. We can pick the governor of Washington, John Arthur Gillatley. Gillatley? What? Who are these dudes? John Arthur Gillatley. Dude, there are so fucking many. Robert Taft, I've heard of him. Oh my god. The fucking man himself. You can have Richard fucking Nixon as head of government. What the fuck? I mean, I suppose it makes sense, but... But also... I don't like it. As we got Hiram Johnson. Or... God, why are there so many? Emmett Anderson, I've heard of him as well. Charles L. McNary, I think I've heard of as well. You know what? Fuck it. I'm gonna Google these guys. I'm gonna make my decision based on that. Just straight up do a Google search. And if this episode, or if I, if you have, like, if you have ideas about who I should play as, even though this episode is not releasing fast enough, I think, for me to maybe be able to internalize this. It might. I'm not quite sure. So, in case, if you feel very strongly about who the president should be, please leave a comment. I'll read them all. Hopefully, I'll read them before I record the next video. Also, in general, if you have tips on how I can win the war, tips on what I should be doing, just aesthetic tips, like things you think I should be doing in terms of like the way I should organize things, because in order to like more accurately or more immersively embody the Pacific States of America and stuff like that. If you've got ideas of doctrine that would be fitting, if you've got ideas about, you know, plans, please share them in the comments down below. I'm very, very, very open to criticism and suggestions. Either way, we are at the end of the video, so thank you so much for watching. If you would like, you can reach me on social media, following the links in the description down below. Twitter and Discord. Twitter, I post bullshit, I post updates about the videos. On Discord, you can talk to me. And you can talk to anyone else in the community as well, and share memes and so on and so forth. Let's see, what else is there? There's, yes, of course, the Patreon. The thing that everyone on YouTube tries to rely on for income. If you'd like, you can support me there. There's only one tier. It's $1 and up, so you can give according to your ability, and everyone receives the same benefits. And that is about it. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time. Goodbye.